The plane took off on schedule from LaGuardia on a bright, clear, sunny summer's day. What a cheerful trio they appeared to be. They were off the ground, westward bound, to the Atheist Convention in L.A. Peter was a lawyer from Manhattan. Mohammed sold used cars in Sheepshead Bay. And Howard practiced dentistry in Woodmere. With the clouds below, they were on the go to the Atheist Convention in L.A.
I'm so glad that we'll be staying at the Hilton.
I can't wait to spend a day in Disneyland.
Did you hear this year they're letting in agnostics?
The convention should be absolutely grand.
There'll be speeches that will ponder our existence.
Religious dogma will come under fierce attack.
That we all once were primates is our motto.
And that Big Bang's not a theory but a fact. Peter ordered white wine with his dinner. Howard and Mohammed asked for gin. There was a chosid in the next row eating kosher.
Could he be so naive
to still believe
that someone up there's watching over him?
Suddenly, there was a big explosion.
Everyone began to scream and wail.
The plane was in a spin and losing altitude.
Pete cried,
"Mercy, Father!"
Mohammed,
"Spare me, Allah!"
And in Hebrew, Howard said,
"Shema Israel!"
I'm so glad that we'll be staying in the Hilton.
I can't wait to spend a day in Disneyland.
Did you hear this? You better than me and Gosling.
The convention should be absolutely grand.
There'll be speeches that will come on our existence.
Religious just don't come under fierce attack.
Just before that final awful impact, while everyone was sure that they would die, somehow, someway, the engines came to life again. Just a few yards from the trees, with what seemed to be great ease, the pilot flew the plane back to the sky. Everyone gave thanks to God in heaven.
It was a miracle
that saved us on this day. The chassid turned and asked the trio with a smile,
"With your true colors showing, will you three still be going
to the Atheist Convention in L.A.?"
Peter's now a priest in Cincinnati. Mohammed built a mosque in Santa Fe.
And Howard is still a dentist out in Woodmere. But now they call him Chaimel, and on Shabbos wears a streimel, 'cause their buried faith ignited while flying on United to the Atheist Convention in L.A.